Welcome to another new vlog, and this time it is a travel vlog. So this winter vacation we planned places to visit are very close to Milan, as every day Italy's COVID rules and restrictions are changing. So we decided we will enjoy but without doing any adventure. So one cold foggy morning we started our journey from Milan Central Station, and our destination, which is only 2 hours journey from Milan, is Verona. We can easily enjoy a day trip by exploring the romantic city of Romeo and Juliet. Now it's time to a small introduction of Verona city. Verona city is a city in northern Italy with a middle-aged old town built at the bank of the river Adige. It's famous for Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet. In this video, I will show you the important places to visit in Verona for a day trip. Now let's enjoy the video. We were very excited for our trip, and within 2 hours we reached Verona Porta Nuova station. This is the surrounding of Verona Porta Nuova station. It is very clean. So after reaching there, we had our breakfast to kickstart our day. Though we have decided already from where exactly we will start our visit, but one more time we wanted to take opinion from others also. We are now heading towards our first point. As Verona is a very small city, most of the places we will cover by walk only. And as per our experience, we prefer to walk, because in a small European city, each turn of a narrow lane has a surprise for you, and you will not get it from Google search. Reached our first point. Our first point is Basilica di San Zeno Maggiore. It is a very beautiful and well-preserved Basilica of Verona. It is constructed between 967 and 1398 AD. And it is made of tufa stone and brick. It is famous as a place of the marriage of Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet. We could not go inside the basilica as it was closed for tourists because of religious services. This tower is at left side of the basilica, and it is a 13th century monastery. And the right side of this basilica is the 12th century slender bell tower. As I told you, every turn has a surprise. Here is also one old structure. I don't know the name of this structure, but it is very old and interesting. Even I couldn't get it from Google search also.
Beautiful local market, just like town, right?
These are open markets. You will find almost all small and big European cities and towns. From there you can get fresh vegetables, fruits, cheese, etc. It is Christmas time, so it is obvious to meet Santa Claus. Now we are on the way to our second point. See the roadside shops. It is full of Christmas decorative items. So beautiful. Really love those stuffs. Now we are heading towards our second point, and our second point is Castello Vecchio Bridge. Can you see the bridge?
Can we cross the bridge?
Yeah, we can.
Oh, that's amazing. Then we see the footage from there.
The bridge is also called Scaliger Bridge or Ponte di Castello Ricci. In Italian, ponte means bridge. As you can see, the bridge is in red brick in the upper part, as are all landmark in Verona from the Scaliger era, and in white marble in the lower one. It includes three spans of decreasing length, starting from the tower at right side, the largest span measuring 48.7 meter, and that the time of its construction, it was the world's largest bridge arch. The bridge was built by Carlo Scarpa, and it was the wonderful construction of the Middle Ages of Verona. Now we are going to the main entrance of the bridge. We will cross the bridge and we will go to the other side of the river bank. As we enter, at the right side of the main entrance of the bridge, there is a museum called Castello Vecchio Museum or Museo di Castello Vecchio. Inside the museum, you will get all the history of the original building and its renovation, and you will also find Scarpa's architectural style in details.
Diego.
Now we are on the bridge, and I would like to tell a little history about this bridge. This bridge took 3 years, between 1354 to 1356 to complete, and the bridge was however totally destroyed by the German troops in 1945, and it reconstructed in between 1949 and 1951, and the reconstructed bridge exactly looks like the original.
Rishi,
we spent some time here and then went to the river bank. Now it's time to go to next point, so we are going towards the third point. See the tower clock, it's very old but still it gives the real time. Here also we found open market, and now you will get a different type of woolen stuff. These are the local snacks like cream roll, candies, different type of candies. Can you see the big arch gate? It is called City Arch Gate. We are not going towards the gate, we are going just opposite of the gate, because Roman Arena is just opposite of this arch gate, and our third point also. Roman Arena, or the Roman Amphitheater in Verona, was built in the 1st century AD to watch the fights of gladiators. Arena of Verona is an open-air Roman amphitheater that is still fully in use today, making it one of the best preserved ancient structure in the world. Verona is often called Little Rome for the state of preservation of its artifacts. Compared to the Colosseum in Rome, the Arena of Verona is less than half the size. Now the most attraction of our Verona trip is Juliet House, and our next point also. Juliet House is a tower house from late 13th and early 14th century. At the beginning of the 20th century, Juliet's house was restored and opened to visitors. Now little history of this house. It is said that Juliet's family was the Capuletti family, or Capuletti in Italian, which means small hats. Over the centuries, the building had been altered and appeared as an anonymous and shabby 19th century building. At the beginning of the 20th century, Antonio Avena, an architect and director of the Verona Museum, started the restoration of the building and trying to bring back its medieval look. In 1968, a Juliet statue was placed in the courtyard of the house just under the famous balcony. Story is incomplete without Romeo. Romeo's house is far from Juliet House, and it is a private inhabited building now. We can see only from the outside. Outside of the door, you can see a board written, "Where is Romeo? I have lost myself." Next point is Juliet's tomb. Juliet's tomb is a stone coffin, empty and without lid. It is inside the underground crypt of the Church of San Francesco al Corso, an old monastery in Verona. Shakespeare, the creator. We are our next point, that is Piazza delle Erbe, or Market Square. It is the oldest square in Verona, and it was once the town's forum during the time of Roman Empire. Here you will find one monumental statue of Dante Alighieri. Coming to the next point, it is Arche Scaligere, or Scala family's tomb. It is very impressive Gothic monumental tomb of Scala family. They are considered one of the most representative example of Italian Gothic architecture and sculpture. We have come to our next point, that is Basilica of Saint Anastasia. And it is the largest church in Verona, built in around 1290. And it has 12 marble pillars which together hold the structure of the basilica. The visitor is struck by two very particular figures that guard and bless the entrance of the basilica. These are the two famous holy water fonts supported by the so-called hunchbacks. It is said that touching a hunchback on the arm brings good luck. Next place is Verona Cathedral or Duomo di Verona. This Duomo was erected after two ancient Christian churches on the same site has been destroyed by an earthquake in 1117. Built in Romanesque style, the cathedral was consecrated on September 13, 1187. The structure was later modified by several renovations, although the plan has remained unchanged. Those who are not able to walk, they have option to explore the city Verona by toy train also, but I don't have much information about that. Backside of this Duomo has a bell tower which is constructed after the church. We have reached our next place and it is another stone bridge called Ponte Pietra crossing the Adige River. The arch at the far right is the only one which escaped destruction in 1945. Four arches of the bridge were blown up by German troops in World War II but rebuilt in 1957. Finally, we have come to our last point, that is Verona Funicular. It is also known as the San Pietro Castle Funicular. Now about this funicular, it is an inclined lift previously operated as a funicular railway. Originally constructed as a funicular, the line opened in 1941 to provide access to the San Pietro Castle. However, the function of this funicular closed 3 years later as San Pietro's function as a tourist attraction failed to materialize at that time.
Wow.
In 2000, the Verona municipal government explored option to reopen the long abandoned railway. Eventually, it was decided to repurpose the funicular as an inclined lift and new service was completed in 2017. From the top, you can enjoy panoramic view of Verona city. San Pietro Castle was closed due to construction work. Our trip ends here. We covered 14 places. There is so much to see in Verona, but daytime is very small in winter. So I wish I will come again in summer to explore other places in Verona. Hope you enjoyed this video. And still you are watching the video, give your suggestion in the comment section and let me know which kind of travel story, like mountain or sea beach or historical place, you love to hear from me. I will come soon with another travel story. Till then, take care and bye-bye.